Building your own cybersecurity lab at home can be one of the most rewarding projects you can undertake as you dive deeper into the world of digital defense. But before you start, it's crucial to figure out what exactly you want to learn. Cybersecurity is a broad field, and there are many different areas of focus. Do you want to understand how to secure networks, find vulnerabilities in software, or practice ethical hacking? The first step in setting up your lab is to decide which aspect of cybersecurity excites you the most. For example, if network security is your focus, your lab will need to include routers, switches, firewalls, and the like. You'll need to get comfortable with concepts like intrusion detection systems and network segmentation. On the other hand, if you're more interested in application security, you'll need to set up environments that allow you to test web applications and understand the vulnerabilities that could potentially be exploited. If ethical hacking is where your interests lie, you'll need to set up a lab that mimics real-world network environments, where you can safely practice penetration testing. Once you know which area you want to focus on, this will help you determine the resources and tools you'll need for your lab. Each focus area requires a different approach and setup, and understanding this will streamline your journey. With a clearer sense of direction, it's time to pick a spot for your lab and gather the necessary gear. Now, you don't need a dedicated room or a massive space. A small corner in your house will work just fine, as long as it allows you to set up without interfering with the rest of your household. You'll need a computer capable of running multiple tasks at once, something with a decent processor, and at least 16 gigabytes of RAM. This will serve as your main workstation where you manage your virtual environments. You'll also need networking equipment, like a router, a switch, and a firewall. These devices allow you to build a mini network that you can control entirely. The router will manage traffic, the switch will connect devices, and the firewall will secure your network. If you want to take things a step further, adding some extra gadgets like old computers, servers, or IoT devices can help you practice on a wider variety of technologies and make your lab setup even more versatile. Now, before we go any further, I've created a step-by-step cybersecurity lab guidebook exclusive to my private community. This isn't your typical lab setup guide. It includes real-world blueprints, downloadable VM configurations, and even templates for simulating attacks. All things I can't share here because, well, YouTube will take down the video. Inside the Academy, you'll get access to hands-on walkthroughs of setups, practical hacking scenarios, and techniques used by top professionals in the field. And for the next 48 hours only, you can use the promo code HACKER30 to get 30% off your first month. That's just $13.99, less than a night out, for resources that could help you land a high-paying cybersecurity gig. Plus, by joining, you directly support this channel and help me make this my full-time job, so I can keep creating content like this and even better. First link in the description. Don't miss out. Alright, next up is the software. This is the brains of your operation. To create a virtualized environment where you can experiment safely, you'll need virtualization software like VMware Workstation, Oracle VM VirtualBox, or Microsoft Hyper-V. These programs allow you to run virtual machines, VMs, on your computer, essentially creating multiple virtual computers within your physical machine. This will allow you to test and practice various operating systems and configurations without the risk of damaging your actual system. Installing a variety of operating systems, like different Linux distributions, Ubuntu, CentOS, etc., and Windows, is a must. It's also wise to include specialized security operating systems like Kali Linux, which comes preloaded with tools for penetration testing and other cybersecurity tasks. In addition to the operating systems, you'll need some security tools tailored to your focus area. For example, network scanners like Nmap can help you explore and map out your network. Vulnerability assessment tools like Nessus will help you identify potential weaknesses in your systems, while intrusion detection systems like Snort can help you monitor and block attacks in real time. These tools are crucial for building your skills and gaining hands-on experience in cybersecurity. Once you've got your gear and software ready, it's time to set up your own mini-internet. This means creating a network that's completely isolated from your home network to avoid any accidental disruptions or security risks. You can achieve this by connecting your networking equipment and setting up a separate network that only your lab machines will connect to. This isolated environment will allow you to safely test and practice without risking anything important. Now you'll want want to configure your virtual machines and network gear to mimic real-world network setups. By doing this, you're creating a hands-on learning environment where you can practice real cybersecurity scenarios, whether it's penetration testing, defending against attacks, or analyzing vulnerabilities. This level of configuration will help you get a feel for the actual challenges faced in a real-world cybersecurity job. After setting everything up, it's time to dive into some practical exercises. Cybersecurity is all about practice, and the best way to learn is to engage with real-life challenges. You can start by testing your own systems for weaknesses. Remember, always do this in your own lab environment and never on systems you don't have permission to test. For example, you might try to breach your own network defenses to see where they're weak and how you can strengthen them. You can also practice defending your network from simulated attacks or exploring new vulnerabilities in your systems. The more you practice, the better you'll become at identifying security flaws and implementing effective defenses. As you continue to learn and practice, it's important to stay up to date with the ever-changing world of cybersecurity. New threats and vulnerabilities are constantly emerging, so you'll need to keep learning to stay ahead. Follow the latest cybersecurity news, join online forums and communities, and participate in projects that challenge your knowledge. By doing this, you'll constantly sharpen your skills and be ready to tackle any new challenge that comes your way. Remember, cybersecurity is a dynamic field, and there's always something new to discover. Lastly, always remember to play it safe and ethical. Only test systems you own or have explicit permission to work on. By following these steps and continuously learning, you'll be on your way to becoming a cybersecurity expert, all from the comfort of your own home. Your lab will not only be a place to practice and learn, but also a space to experiment, innovate, and develop new skills that will serve you well in the world of digital security.